Hello, this is Rick Tarrant, and today we're talking with DeGarmo and Key.
No, I just produced his album, and so I spent a lot of time with him. But Jesse is a really fun guy, and he's easy to get along with.
So why don't you tell me?
Well, okay, take number three.
We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back. This is Rick Tarrant, inviting you to stay around for the next few minutes as we review the new album from DeGarmo and Key. It's entitled Commander Sozo in the Charge of the Light Brigade. Now, you may be asking yourself, what is or who is Commander Sozo?
Interesting you should ask.
Here's Ed DeGarmo.
Who is Commander Sozo? Dana, who is Commander Sozo?
Commander Sozo is a fictitious character. Basically, the word sozo is taken from the Greek, and it means to save, to heal, or to replenish. And sozo is pretty much the theme of our ministry. The whole idea behind DeGarmo and Key and our music is to save and to replenish and restore people to a relationship with Jesus Christ. So that's why we dreamed up the character Commander Sozo.
If you don't like that definition, it's a little Oriental guy.
If that isn't, that's right. And he's going to start a motorcycle company.
And that should answer any questions you might have concerning the identity of Commander Sozo. Here's the first single from the album. It's a duet with Dana Key and Jesse Dixon. Listening to a review of the DeGarmo and Key album, Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. This is Rick Tarrant. From their home of Memphis, Tennessee, I talked with Ed DeGarmo and Dana Key, and Ed tells us that the song Destined to Win was written with Jesse Dixon specifically in mind.
About a year ago, we started conceiving a tour, and we were looking for a particular artist to do that tour with. Somebody that we felt like that could go beyond some cultural barriers. Help us to give a better rounded concert. Somebody that could also communicate very well with the audience. And we searched through many artists. And then Jesse Dixon's name came up. And Jesse Dixon is the one artist that Dana and I have played with in the past few years that we swore that we would never follow him on stage again. Because he was so good and so hot. So what do? We go out and we book a 90-day tour with Jesse Dixon opening the show. Right? And as a result, Dana and I got together and wrote a song called Destined to Win. And the song was written with the tour in mind and with the ministry that we wanted to see happen on the tour, and we thought that it would be, you know, really brilliant if somehow we could get all this to work together. And that's how it ended up being a duet, and that's how Jesse is on this tour. And it's kind of like the theme of everything.
Join us again next time as we continue to review Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's the latest release from DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant, and today we're talking with DeGarmo and Key.
I guess in many ways this record's kind of a conceptual kind of album.
Yes, this album borders on being a concept album. One of the themes that run... Take two.
We'll be back in a moment. This is Rick Tarrant, welcoming you back to our review of Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. That's the name of the new album from DeGarmo and Key, and according to Dana, it is a concept album. And the concept is...
Christian activism.
Which means...
Get up and get busy.
One of the songs on the new album is entitled Activate, which puts into music the message that DeGarmo and Key are taking across America.
We believe that one of the diseases that is currently running through the church is apathy. And we feel like that it's time for Christians to get up off the pews and take the gospel and the message of Jesus Christ to their friends, to their neighbors, to the streets. And it should be part of their thinking process when they vote. It should be part of their thinking process when they go to school, when they drive. We want to make Christ a part of everyone's daily life. And to do that, we're going to have to activate the church. We're going to have to encourage the church to be active every day as active Christians participating in bringing the kingdom of God into the world. Who's gonna stand when everyone wants to sit down? Who will be there when fragile hearts crash to the ground? Who's gonna know when pain rushes in with the tide? Who's gonna see if everyone closes their eyes?
listening to a review of Commander Sozo in the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's the new album from DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant. As Dana said earlier, this is a concept album, and the concept is directed towards Christians, and even more specifically, church youth groups.
I think one of the things we're trying to say is that living the Christian life is everyone's responsibility. It's not just the pastor's responsibility, but it's every Christian's responsibility, and we can't leave the expansion of the kingdom of God in the world. We can't leave it to the professionals. It's not for the singers and the evangelists to do. It's for every Christian to do.
Seems like James said something like that. Faith without works is dead. Makes perfect sense.
Join us again next time as we continue to review Commander Sozo in the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's the new album from DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant, talking with DeGarmo and Key.
This particular album, I think that in many ways we aimed it at, you know, the church youth group audience. I'm not trying to say that there's nothing on there for the fellow who's my age.
How old is that? It's 17, 18?
17, 18. Yeah. That's what I meant to say.
We'll be back in a moment. This is Rick Tarrant inviting you back to our review of Commander Sozo in the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's the latest album from Ed DeGarmo and Dana Key. If you'll study a discography of DeGarmo and Key songs, you'll discover a number of tunes that deal with the Second Coming. Songs over the years like When He Comes Back, Ready or Not, and their number one song, Alleluia, Christ is Coming. And this new album continues with the tradition.
The reason why we sing a lot about the Second Coming is I can't think of any more timely message to convey to someone than Jesus is coming back soon to perhaps spur them to get up off the pew and get busy doing the job that we're supposed to do as Christians.
I think lyrically that you'll find this album more challenging. I think the lyrics challenge a reaction. They want a response. The lyrics want a response. I just think that they elicit some kind of emotion from you.
Christmas is coming. Are you ready? No, Are You Ready was from DeGarmo Key's last album. Jesus is Coming is from their new album, and it's called Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. This is Rick Tarrant, and we're reviewing this album today. And in talking with Eddie and Dana, I've found that they don't view their music as just musical, spiritual entertainment, but rather they see it as a form of evangelism, a tool that can be used by the church.
We consider the records a tool, and it's a tool for evangelism, but we realize that the tools have to be placed in the hands of Christians. And they're, I guess they could be considered like tracks, except for they're musical tracks. And we hope that people will play the music for their friends, that they will enjoy the music and be exhorted and encouraged by the music, but they'll also use the music to win their friends to Christ.
Evangelism to the church, that's our ministry.
Keep listening for more as we bring you Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade from DeGarmo and Key. Hi, this is Rick Tarrant, talking with Ed DeGarmo and Dana Key.
Not me, no. Eddie and I have never had any trouble with that because we've only had temporary things. God giveth and the IRS taketh away, is what I always say.
We'll be back in a moment. This is Rick Tarrant, inviting you to join us for the next few minutes as we review Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's the latest album from DeGarmo and Key. One of the songs on this new album deals with the temporal things of life, the things in life that we work for and strive to achieve that really don't have any lasting value. Ed tells us about temporary things.
It seems like that many of us spend our lives building treasures, you know, building castles made of sand or trying to acquire great wealth or trying to acquire fame or status. It seems like all of Scripture teaches us to not place our priorities in those type of things. And I think that what we're trying to say in the song is that many times those things dictate our life. I mean, they demand us to do certain things. We have to take certain jobs. We divide our time. We have to do this to try to keep up our status or to become famous or to get power. On the song, in many ways, it's just kind of like a simple prayer. I don't want to spend my life living for those type of things. Those things that won't last for eternity. And it seems like that if we could focus our lives on the eternal things, I mean, it would make a drastic difference in the way that we carried ourselves day to day. It really would.
Right before your eyes. light starts to fade. And you wonder what it is you're living for.
Listening to a review of Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's the latest album from DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant. In years gone by, the music of DeGarmo and Key often dealt with street themes, songs directed more towards the non-Christian who is still searching. The Charge of the Light Brigade album, on the other hand, is more church-oriented, and while you probably won't hear their songs on Sunday by the choir, the message is directed towards believers. Ed DeGarmo explains why.
I mean, in the last couple of years, we've seen a real focal point happen in our ministry. And what we're seeing happen is we're seeing that church groups are really getting behind what we're doing. And we are evangelizing through the church. We're seeing the non-Christian kids that we see come to our concerts, a lot of times are responsible because a church group bought them.
Join us again next time as we continue to review Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade from DeGarmo and Key. Hello, this is Rick Tarrant, and today we're talking with DeGarmo and Key.
Our world is becoming increasingly violent. You know, yesterday there's a car bombing in Lebanon, train wreck here and a plane crash there. And suddenly you find yourself building a wall around your heart.
We'll be back in a moment. This is Rick Tarrant, welcoming you back to our review of Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's the new album from DeGarmo and Key. On the morning of April 4th, 1985, DeGarmo and Key joined with 60 other Christian artists from around the globe to form The Cause, an acronym for Christian Artists United to Save the Earth. Dana told me that he was somewhat embarrassed that Christians did not respond sooner and talks about the dangers of becoming apathetic.
I was, you know, a little bit disappointed that it took us Christians so long to rally behind this cause. But when I first heard about the famine in Ethiopia, I thought, well, here's another famine, and next year there's going to be a famine someplace else, and what can we do? And I'm really glad that the Lord spoke to a whole lot of us, and we decided finally to get up and collectively do something. And I hope that this spirit of activism persists for until Jesus comes. apathy alert basically arose out of a little bit of depression that I had. I read the newspaper avidly every morning. First thing I do is have my morning coffee and read the paper. And I love to get home in the afternoon and watch the news. And some of my favorite programs are news shows. And in fact, I've become a news junkie. But the problem with being a news addict is that the news is generally, probably 95% of it is very, very depressing. And our world is becoming increasingly violent. And if you watch the news over a long period of time, you become desensitized to the affairs that are going on overseas. And the Lord spoke to me in the midst of that depression as I sought Him, and He just told me, He said, Dana, you need to be very careful that you don't become apathetic by watching the news a lot and seeing other people's pain and not feeling or sharing grief with other people. And you need to be sensitive to the Holy Spirit and pray for these people. And so I had to limit myself to basically how much news I ingested into my mind. An apathy alert is basically a little song about becoming apathetic because of the amount of bad news that we receive.
This is Rick Tarrant, inviting you to join us again next time as we continue our review of Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. And we'll talk more with DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant, and today we're talking with DeGarmo and Key.
No, it's going to be a lot cheaper. We spent way too much money on 666, and we're going to have to hold the budget down.
I think we're spending twice as much money on this new video as we did on the last one, exactly. And we're dedicated to doing something that's better.
We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back to our review of Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade, the latest album from DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant. If you've watched any television lately, you may have caught glimpses of the DeGarmo and Key music video entitled 666, a song dealing with the Antichrist and the end times. Entertainment Tonight, The Today Show, the CBS Evening News, and even the Wall Street Journal have been covering the controversy that arose when MTV originally turned down the airing of 666. Ed DeGarmo.
We approached it from a quality standpoint. We said, well, if we make a video that's good enough to go on MTV, we think that we deserve as much of a shot as Bruce Springsteen or anybody else. If we make a video that's bad and they throw it back in our face, we don't feel like it should be played. MTV came back at us and they said, guys, your video's too violent. And basically we said, wow, what are you talking about? And the video, the first uncut version, has a particular scene in it in which this Antichrist 666 is set on fire. And the whole thought behind this is that this fire doesn't hurt this individual. He comes out of it okay. And it was replaced by a scene in which we allude to the fact that the Antichrist is behind such things in the end times as war and nuclear bombs and things of that nature, which really made for a funny story in the Wall Street Journal, because MTV that said, what was the line? They said they knocked out the flames but went for a nuclear bomb. That's what it said.
666 finally made it into MTV's music rotation. And now DeGarmo and Key are planning to follow that up with a music video entitled Competition. It's from Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. You're listening to a song from the new DeGarmo and Key album, Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's entitled Competition. Dana Key tells us what this song is all about.
In competition, we're talking about everyone from Wall Street to the church that feels that they're in competition with the church down the street. Jesus said that Christians should be recognized by our love for one another and our sharing. And competition is a disease in America. We've been taught from a very early age that to really be successful, you got to pull yourself up by your own bootstraps, and that winning is everything. But Jesus, of course, teaches us that winning is not everything. Loving and sacrificing is more important than winning.
This is Rick Tarrant, inviting you to join us again next time when we bring you more from Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade, the new album from DeGarmo and Key. Hi, this is Rick Tarrant, and today we're talking with DeGarmo and Key.
You know, the good thing about it is our record company has never told us anything that they want on a record, basically. We send them the record when we're through with it, and they tell us whether they really like it or really don't, and sometimes they do. Sometimes they don't.
We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back to our review of the new album from DeGarmo and Key. It's entitled Captain Sozo.
It's not Captain Sozo, it's Commander Sozo. Oh. There's a very fine distinction between Captain and Commander.
Okay, Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. This is Rick Tarrant. One of the things I've often found interesting about DeGarmo and Key was their reputation for being a hard-driving rock and roll band that would blow your socks off, as it were. If you'll go back and listen to their albums from the mid to early 70s, they're not hard rock and roll at all. They're good, they're tight, they were contemporary, but they certainly were not a Christian version of Molly Hatchet. I asked the guys how they got this bad reputation.
Man, we really don't know.
We've never done heavy metal, and we've never done what I call hard rock, and so where we got the hard rock reputation, I guess your guess would be as good as mine, because we really couldn't say.
We do. I don't know. I mean, I guess we do rock music, but it's a little left of the center of what happens in Christian music. And I think
I wouldn't call it Ted Nugent.
No.
Cat Scratch Fever. I wouldn't call it that.
No, I wouldn't either.
This new album from Eddie and Dana is probably the most up-tempo record they've ever done, but there are a couple of ballads, and here's one of them. It's entitled Casual Christian from Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade.
It's more than a wish, more than a daydream. It's more than just a passing whim. Yes, I've said this all before, a thousand times or more. I don't want to waste my life in chains of sin.
This is Rick Tarrant, inviting you to join us again as we continue our review of Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade, the new album from DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant with DeGarmo and Dana Key.
I mean, if you ever ride on a bus for 15 hours a day and get up and play a two-hour concert and do the same thing for 6 or 8 months, you'll see very quickly that how imperfect that you can be.
Would you testify to that?
I would testify to that about Eddie, of course.
My wife would definitely testify to it.
We'll be back in a moment. This is Rick Tarrant, reviewing the new album from DeGarmo and Key, Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. And speaking of charges, over the past 5 to 10 years, as Christian music has progressed and become more professional, some people are now charging that it has become too slick and too worldly. DeGarmo responds.
I don't know. I mean, we hear some people say that. And, I mean, have we gotten too slick? I think that at times that we've gotten too glamorous, and we've looked for the tinsel and looked for the glitter. I think the thing that's happening is that in many ways Christian music is coming up and even surpassing the world standards. I mean, hey, let's face it, until 100 years ago all the great art came from the church, and in the past 100 years it stopped, and now it's starting to come again. I think that professionalism is welcome. And the records are better. The radio stations sound better. We have more listeners. We reach more people.
Jesus said that we'd recognize trees by their fruit. And the fruit of our ministry follows us. And we're perfectly prepared to just allow people, if they want to judge us by the fruit that follows our ministry.
To the new album from DeGarmo and Key, Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. The song's entitled Rise Up. This is Rick Tarrant. And Dana tell us about their call to excellence in their music ministry, and they respond to criticisms that are often launched against contemporary Christian music.
You know, dealing with the people that are totally against what we do, I'm not going to name any names, but there are several that have written books, and I think that we even heard a TV preacher preaching against us last week.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Every time I see that happen, man, I just thank God that we live in America, because it's a free country and they can say or do whatever they want to do.
Excellence has to always be our standard, and we shouldn't do anything less than the very best that we can do for Christ's sake. At the same time, to achieve excellence, we don't want to adopt worldly methodology. The world has its own standard of excellence, and the world has its own way of achieving that excellence. And we don't want to achieve excellence in the same ways that they do. But at the same time, we need to do our job the very best that we can, for Christ's sake.
Join us again next time as we bring you more from the new album, Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's from DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant with DeGarmo and Key.
I remember in Bible college how they used to talk about being so heavenly minded that you're no earthly good.
And now you're so earthly minded you're no heavenly good.
I'm going to have to do my interview separate from Ed.
Ed's gonna have to He's the in. One that said that. I didn't.
I'm
going
to have to do it separate from Rick, too.
We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back to a review of Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. It's the new album from DeGarmo and Key. This is Rick Tarrant. Throughout the centuries, Christians have felt compelled to write songs about our home in the future. Heaven is what I'm talking about. Great composers like Watts, Martin Luther, and more recently, DeGarmo and Key. On the new album, they've got a song entitled No More Goodbyes, and Dana tells us about that song.
That's the first song that I've ever written about heaven specifically. I wrote the song. It started out as a poem that I wrote for my wife. And, you know, we travel a lot. And when we leave, it's a very tearful separation. And the poem to my wife was basically just to convey to her that there would be a day that when she and I would not have to say goodbye again. And I didn't mean the day that I retire. I meant the day that we both go to heaven. Because in heaven, we'll never have to say goodbye again. And that's how the song got its beginning.
No More Goodbyes. It's from DeGarmo and Key and their new album, Commander Sozo in the Charge of the Light Brigade. This is Rick Tarrant inviting you to join us next time as we continue to review the new album from Ed DeGarmo and Dana Key. This is Rick Tarrant with DeGarmo and Key.
We actually steal all of our songs.
so we don't have to write anything.
No, on this album, I wrote the majority of the lyrics and Eddie wrote the majority of the music. In fact, I wrote the majority of this album. I wrote all the good songs on this album.
He lies.
We'll be back in a moment. Hello, this is Rick Tarrant, welcoming you back to our review of the new album from DeGarmo and Key. It's entitled Commander Sozo in the Charge of the Light Brigade. You know, the inspiration for a number of DeGarmo and Key songs come from a variety of sources, whether it's a scripture reference or perhaps a sermon they've heard, maybe a personal encounter that has affected their life, and even, believe it or not, dreams. As a matter of fact, the title song from this album was inspired by a couple of dreams.
We had some strange dreams on the bus.
Yeah, we've had some really weird dreams on that bus. I'll tell you.
Dana has spiritual dreams. He really does. I have dreams about monsters chasing me and stuff.
I've never dreamed about monsters or anything since I was a kid. And Eddie's talking about bad dreams on the bus. We used to travel in a motorhome, and we used to load a lot of equipment in a bunk, and I was sleeping underneath that bunk, and in the middle of my sleep I heard a voice yelling to me to wake up and get up, and I rose up very quickly, and as I rose up where my head was laying, a big box fell off the bunk and crashed there, and me just barely missed my head, and I thought somebody in the band had yelled to me to wake up, and I was thanking everyone, the band, for yelling, and they looked at me like I was crazy because they hadn't said a word. So I do think the Lord speaks to you in dreams occasionally.
Sat down to rest last night, slipped into a dream. Shadows fell across the world, the darkness was extreme. We all sat there mindlessly, staring at the storm. Just when all seemed lost and hopeless, there came a mighty roar. It was the charge of the Light Brigade, the charge of the Light Brigade, with the spiritual serenade. Came the charge of the Light Brigade. The poor and afflicted all had enough to eat. The message of the angel gospel echoed in the street. I saw the angels dancing on the wind. The Son of God was shining brightly. Death came to an end. It was the charge of the Light Brigade, the charge of the Light Brigade, with the spiritual serenade. Came the charge of the Light.
Listening to the new album from DeGarmo and Key, Commander Sozo in the Charge of the Light Brigade. Dana tells us about the title song.
It really was. Actually, it was a part of several dreams.
that I had, one that I had, and one that our bass player Tommy Cathy had had. But we visualize a day when Christians will preach both kinds of the gospel, the gospel that helps people come into the kingdom and to trust Jesus Christ, and also a gospel that has social responsibility where we take care of our fellow men. And we visualize that day in the coming of a kingdom where Jesus Christ will reign personally, and that song was just about that hope for that kingdom to come, and for the Light Brigade, which is basically Christians in the church, to take up their responsibility until that day comes.
You've been listening to the new album from DeGarmo and Key, Commander Sozo and the Charge of the Light Brigade. This is Rick Tarrant. Thanks for listening.